People, welcome back to Politics Watch, People's Channel, the Sir P. Now, as I can see right now, we switch over to the burning fire because this channel is lighting a fire under certain people's skin. And I just want these people to know, especially those who are loyal to certain criminal politicians and certain criminals who are associated with these politicians. I'm just letting you know from now, it's not going to stop. So, don't think when you get all heated and jump in the comment section to defend your favorite Don or your favorite crooked politician, don't think it has any effect except motivating me to go even harder. Now, some of you may remember, well, there's no way you can forget the recent King Alarm incident with the 16-year-old, right? Now, I've been in communication with someone who's a part of, who's a family member to the young man. His name was Tayshaun Marshawn, right? And a lot of times when these incidents happen, we just hear about a 16-year-old boy, a 25-year-old man, a 40-year-old woman, and it makes people sound like an item. These are human beings, they all have a story. And what I'm going to do now is humanize Tayshaun Marshawn. Because a lot of it's easier for people to be all cool and tough when they just hear, oh, 20-year-old from so and so. But we're going to do a brief look into who this young man was. And I'm going to address King Alarm again. Right. Now, Tayshaun Marshawn was 16 years old. He was the only child for his mother and the fourth child for his father. So, Tayshaun Marshawn's mother no longer has a child. But I guess that's fine for some of you because some people claim say, what to him deserve, him deserve it. We must up on road the more than night. I see people write all them kind of nonsense in the comment section. But that's fine. I hope one day you people never have to go through something like this. So big up on yourself. As I said, he was the only child of his mother and the fourth child of his father. Tayshaun was a sergeant in the cadet, the Jamaica's cadet force. He was well respected by his peers. He was well respected by his instructors, his seniors. And again, anybody who have any experience with cadet will tell you that in any high school you go or an institution you go, the cadet boys are normally a bit more disciplined than the average student because the cadet force instill those things inside of them. It's like a mini army, right? It's like a stepping stone to the army. A lot of people who leave cadet naturally just go into JDF, right? See, this young man who was a member of the cadet, who was the only child for his mother, right, go up on the road one night and never come home to her, right? And again, the conclusion that the Jamaican people are supposed to accept is that this young man was suicidal, because that could be the only justification for him to not only have fake gun on him, but to then reach for it in the presence of two armed King Alarm security guards who already have their weapons pointed at him. See, the only rationale you could come to justify an action, since that is what we were told happening, and a little highly questionable video that we saw released, only conclusion you could draw is that Tayshaun Marshawn was suicidal, according to what King Alarm wants us to believe. It's the only justification we can think of. There is no logical reason as to why a 16-year-old youth who clearly have sense, who's a member of the cadet force, would get stopped on the road by these King Alarm officers, see that there are two men armed with their weapons already drawn, and then decide, yeah, I'm going to draw for my piece of a gun. But a lot of people have already made up their mind about the story. Those who believe say yes, the youth was some kind of Hollywood 87 acting, because that's what he would be, to be walking around with fake gun and I'm gonna pull it on King Alarm. And the rest of us who think King Alarm are not being honest and don't trust that second video, because as I said, first of all, just the angle alone with how the weapon fly out of him waist and into the car defies the laws of physics. Second, the motion he would need to reach down in his waist, pull up, that motion never take place. The shirt was up, and then as his hand was coming down, we see something flick out of his waist and dropping out of the car. He would need to dig down into his waist to lift up his hand, right? And then, let's say he gets shot, that's when the motion of the weapon would fly out of him on. But then, we can clearly see that the youth shirt lift up, and as his hand is coming back down, him get shot, and then in a physics defying moment, this black object just fly out from his left hand side and just so happened to drop in at the car. That's an up and down motion, right? And this is without him reaching into his waist. Now, as somebody with military experience, and anybody who's ever handled any kind of weapon and has ever had to pull a weapon from their waist, you will know that video does not match how somebody would need to take a weapon out their waist. Your hands can be up in the air, coming back down, and then shot go off and things flick out of your waist. That's movie stuff. That's Hollywood, people. He would need to, the motions we would see on camera is him using that left hand to go down in his waist first. Then he would need to come up. And then in the motion of coming up, that is when, let's say theoretically speaking, him get hit by the first couple rounds and then the weapon fly out of hand. Now let me tell you something. That weapon, if you have a weapon in your hand, I ask anybody to recreate this scene. Get one of your bridge in them, right? Recreate the scene. You don't even have to need a weapon. Put anything in your waist, right? And get somebody to stand in front of you, right? And then reach for the thing in your hand and hold on upon it like you just pull a weapon out of your waist. Then make somebody push you or punch you or something, and you will see. The next thing that would happen is you would let go of that weapon. It will drop to the floor, directly to the floor. It wouldn't flick up in the sky and then drop back down in a driver's seat. That's movie stuff, people. Just like in the movie, when somebody get hit with a round in the movie, what happen? Them fly gone back into the wall. Right? That's what people think happen. But anybody who's been in a real life situation like that and seen somebody get hit with a round, you know what actually happened is you fall dead flat on the ground. When people get hit with rounds, they don't fly back way. Them drop directly to the ground. Like how you see Tashan drop in this video. This man get shot and weapon flick out time and go under the sky. That's movie stuff, people. This is why I don't trust the video. That video was put together by somebody who made or who watched a lot of movies and think that's how these things work. I've seen men get hit with rounds multiple times, all different type of calibers, and every single time them and them weapon drop directly to the ground. The little 9mm can make the man flick up the gun in the air and drop in the car. That's nonsense, people. That's theatrics. I don't buy it. And as a matter of fact, as I said, those King Alarm officers violated multiple civil, I don't know if it says laws or legislations or what, because I don't know what the legal term you'd use. But King Alarm, no security company in Jamaica, don't have the right to call over nobody and dig them up. And act like police. Security companies not on the right to come stop nobody and search nobody. They have no such power. On the public street, on the normal road, a security company is no different from a civilian. Let me repeat that. On the public street, a security company has no more power than a civilian. This is why them can't put on siren and drive around traffic. All of their legislation is built around protecting private property. And when they're on that private property, they have a certain amount of... As a matter of fact, even the laws that govern them are not much different to the laws that govern regular civilians. It's normal self-defense law. Them can just walk on upon a property, see Tom Johnson stand upon the property and just open fire upon him. They can defend themselves, yes. They can protect property. But people need to realize these are not... security officers don't work under the same protocols as police. And another thing that nobody's talking about is after the youth them run gone down the road, the trigger happy clone in the passenger seat jump out of the car and fire off at the youth down the road as he's running away. So his back is turned and he's running away. In the night, you can't see who down the road and you open fire. So you endanger the public. So even if them claim, oh, they are now exonerated from what they did to Tayshaun Marshall, they still need to get hauled before the courts. Because that one will come out of the car and shoot off at them down the road. You're no longer a threat. First of all, they were never a threat because it's not like you're in a shootout. But you jump out of the car, fire a shot down the road. You don't know who down the road. But we have to be honest with ourselves here. The reason why them do it, the reason why them behave like this, is because of where them buck up on the tree, youth. If them did ears are breaking, going up at Cherry Garden or Narbrook, and them a patrol up there and see three youth, and those youth have a certain look to them, I guarantee you this would never happen. Because they'd be worried, and they would want, first of all, they would assume saw somebody important pick me. And they don't want that kind of problem. This is the kind of Jamaica we live in, and who vex just vex. As I said, people need to stop acting like these things don't still happen in 2019. That split second decision, oh, you're going to deal with somebody, or police deal with people, or security deal with people. In Jamaica, that split second decision is usually done based on the way you look and the area where you stand up, you know. The fire now stop burning. As I said, anytime people listen to any of my videos and feel like I step on them con, feel free to just go watch another channel. We now stop burning the fire. We now stop talking about youths like Tayshaun Marshall and my Kingdom video. People in the comment section are telling me about. Yo, that gone long time. So what? It doesn't matter what gone long time. We're talking about Jamaica and how Jamaica got to where it is. So how can you do that without first talking about the past? Yes, it's enough on a fool. How can you talk about, when have you ever seen a house burn down? And the fire marshal turn up and say, yo, the house burned down already, man, come and go home. No, they recreate things from start to finish. They go right back. Only a fool said those words. How Jamaica is in 2019 is not because of what started in 2018. We have to go back to the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. That's how we get to see where Jamaica is now. So, all you people who loyal to this Dan and that Dan and this party and that party, the fire now stop burning. As a matter of fact, that's why I changed my intro to a fire. It will not stop burning. All you crooked politicians who do things years ago and things that, boy, me get it. Once I see anything out there when we can present to the people, it will be presented. Simple as that. This channel is called Politics Watch, it's not called Frenting. It's not called Smile and Laugh. It's not called Smile Jamaica, it's Morning Time. It's Politics Watch. Me and my subscribers, we look out for things in Jamaican society, which is usually around politics, which need to be called out. Get used to it or move on to another channel. I do follow-ups on cases. The Spanish Town Road Cops, me go to follow up on that. You think me forget about that? The Simone Collymore case, follow up on it at home, because don't think nothing can slide under the carpet. All of these incidents, the Maypen incident, follow up at home. I don't want nobody to get comfortable. Don't get comfortable. So you can tell your favorite politician, or you can tell it done, but nothing is going to change. I'm sorry. Until the breath stop blowing through my body, we're going to defend youths. We're going to defend the people. Wrong is wrong and right is right. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Growing slowly but surely. Please like, comment, share the video. Have a great day, people.